Live from CNBC Studio at the Singapore Exchange, this is Street Signs.
Well, coming up next, U.S. stocks have posted their best day in nearly 3 years. Are the good times back again, or should investors be worried about a global trade start? We'll find out with Joel Shulman in just 2 quick minutes. Well, Joel Shulman is CEO and CIO at Entrepreneur Shares. He joins us live on the line from Boston. Joel, good to have you back on the program. Thanks so much for joining us today. Joel, let me ask you, what do you make of the sell-off and then recovery that we've seen, or partway recovery we've seen in the markets? Has this all been an overreaction, do you think?
Well, actually, this is a very unusual situation. I mean, if you go back over the last 60 years, the 3,000 trading weeks, we've only had a dozen or so time periods like this where there was a 5% drop-off and then a subsequent 3% or more increase in the subsequent week. Now, this is clearly attributed to the trade imbalance with China. And by the way, this is a long overdue problem. And people may forget that 25 years ago, China was only 6% of the U.S. GDP, and now it's about two-thirds of the GDP. And by the way, 25 years ago, it was about 6% of the Euro GDP. It's now about the same. And so this problem that we're now addressing here in the U.S. is really a global problem, with Japan and Korea on the front lines, you know, that may receive the most pain from this trade imbalance if it continues.
So what do you do if you're invested in these markets right now, Joel? What are you telling the people that are calling you and saying, you know, in this type of sell-off or in this type of buyback that we're seeing in the markets, how do you trade it?
Well, so first of all, we have, you know, with the U.S. Entrepreneurs, large cap entrepreneurs, I mean, they're up. They were the number one fund in the January and February, according to the Wall Street Journal. They're up almost, you know, 9.5% year to date. The global markets are still negative. The MSCI, the S&P is slightly negative. It's almost zero. The U.S. large caps, and actually even the U.S. small caps, are leading the market. But it's really the global entrepreneurs that are driving the growth. And as you mentioned beforehand, it's really tech that's driving it. Companies like Netflix, which is up 56% year-to-date, Square, which is up 49% year-to-date, Amazon up about 28%. These global entrepreneurial companies are driving it. But the trade imbalance and this issue is really critical. If we address it and we can take care of it, then it's good long-term. But if it's not taken care of, there's going to be continued problems globally. And again, Europe, Japan, Korea, these countries in particular are going to suffer the most, of course, U.S. as well.
Well, the U.S. is going to take a hit, that's for sure. I think the question is, how do you protect yourself for the volatility that we're seeing on the markets, Joel? Because, you know, rides like this where the Dow drops 700 points is unusual, to say the least, but it is extreme. And if you're invested in the markets, you're likely to have lost quite a bit of money last Friday.
You lost a lot of money last week. You're down close to 5.5% or so. You gained back a lot this week. And again, it was the first time in many years that this has happened. And again, it's only a dozen times in the last 60 years that we've seen this sort of volatility. This is an unusual circumstance. I think long term, the U.S. markets and global markets are fine. I think U.S. markets, global entrepreneurs in particular, very strong. U.S. markets, small cap. I mean, small caps are still up, you know, 3.7% if you look at the Russell 2000 growth. I mean, we have a fund that's up 5.2%, and that's just this month. I mean, I'm sorry, this month is 3.4%, 2.7%. The 5.2 and 3.7% were year-to-date. So you're still seeing pockets of growth and appreciation, and I think in the U.S. markets in particular, we've got low inflation, we've got very stable markets, we still have strong growth in these companies, and I think the markets will continue to be higher through this year. We're going to see volatility, but through this year, things will get better. And if we can solve the trade imbalance, things can really explode, particularly for these entrepreneurial companies, the small entrepreneurial companies, which are currently locked out of China due to the forced joint ventures and the forced technology transfers.
Indeed. Okay. Joel, look, we do appreciate your time today. Thank you so much for chatting to us here on Street Signs.